Christians, today is the fourth Sunday out of five in preparation for Great Lent. I kind of like to call it the preseason. For those of us that are into sports, we know what preseason is. It's a time of getting ready. For our children, when they go to school, when they first start school in September, they don't start right into the middle of lessons, but they always have a few lessons or a few days where they're kind of warming up. They're kind of refreshing what they remember, what they know, and they're getting ready so that they can get the school year going and that they can be successful. It's the same with the rest of us when we get a new job. When we first go into the job, they don't just sit us down and say, here you go ahead. They give us training. We take time and we learn the job and we get ready so that when it is called upon us to be able to perform the duties of our job, we're ready to do so. It's exactly the same in the church. So today, being the Sunday of the Last Judgment, also the last day of which we have meat until the Lord's resurrection, it is the fourth in the five Sundays. The first one, which is one of my favorite feasts, is the Sunday of Zacchaeus. And it doesn't officially belong to the Lenten Triodion. It's the Sunday that's outside of the Lenten Triodion. The way I like to look at it is, it's the Sunday that tells us to get ready to get ready. That's in the Orthodox Church, you find things like that, which is really cool. So, the second Sunday, hopefully we all know, which is the Publican and the Pharisee, it is the first Sunday of the Lenten Triodion. Then we have last Sunday, which is the Sunday of the Prodigal Son. Today being the Sunday of the Last Judgment, and next Sunday, which brings a close to the period of preparation, to the end of preseason, as we call it, which is Forgiveness Sunday. And each of these five Sundays is extremely important to us. St. John Chrysostom, in his sermon for Forgiveness Sunday, talks about five paths to repentance. And these paths are the condemnation of our own sins, prayer, humility, almsgiving, and of course forgiveness of our neighbor's sins against us. These are really important for us to understand because, well, first of all, they come from St. John Chrysostom, and he's one of the greatest saints in the church. And when we listen to what these five paths to repentance are, and let them sink in, condemnation of our own sins, take a look at Zacchaeus. What happened in the Gospel of Zacchaeus? He condemned his own sins publicly in front of everyone that was in his house. Lord, if I've taken anything from anyone by false accusation, I restore to him fourfold. He condemned his own sins publicly in front of everyone. We have the Sunday of the Publican and the Pharisee, where we see the two of them when they went to the temple to pray. The Pharisee, as much as he was righteous in his prayer, he actually hurt himself by the foolish words that he uttered in thanking God that he is not like other men. He wasn't. But as soon as he started to do that, pride set in. We take a look at the prayer of the publican, earnest prayer from the heart, Lord, have mercy on me, a sinner. Then we take a look at a perfect example of humility, just last Sunday, in the parable of the prodigal son. How the son, he humbled himself so much because of what he had done. He had taken his father's life earnings, and he had wasted them on harmless and riotous living. And when he finally realized what he had done, he could have just stayed away, he could have just found a tribe of people, and as he said, he would have been filled with the husks that the pigs did eat, the husks of corn. And yet, what did he decide to do? He decided to humble himself. Ultimate humility, come back and say, Father, I'm no more worthy to be called your son. Make me as one of your servants. And he didn't care, he didn't stop. He came and he said that, and he fell at his father's feet. We also see the love of a father, which is exactly the same love that our father has for us. And that is immediately, as soon as we repent, as soon as we show that humility, he forgives us each and every one of our sins. That's all that he wants. Today, as we heard in the Gospel, the Sunday of the Last Judgment, it is about more concrete acts. It is about what are we doing for others. Feeding the sick and the hungry, and looking after those that are the hungry, look after the sick, clothe the naked. Very, very specific things that we can say, yes, I did, or no, I did not do that. And next Sunday is an even more physical manifestation of what we have to do. The forgiveness of our neighbor's sins against us, it's Forgiveness Sunday. The gospel next week, when we hear it, is very direct from our Lord. If you forgive not men their trespasses, neither will your heavenly Father forgive you. Plain and simple, really simple words. That's why when we say the Lord's Prayer, it is so important for us to understand. Right? Forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. If we haven't forgiven others, then our Lord God and Savior Jesus Christ will not forgive us. Very plain and simple. And that's not an easy thing to do. Whether it's somebody out on the street that has cut us off on the highway, or whether it's in town, someone takes our parking spot, or butts in line in the store, whatever it may happen to be, those little things, they upset us. And what upsets us even more are the sins and transgressions that we have against each other, our own family, whether it's our parish family, our own family. We do simple little things and we offend each other. Sometimes we do things and we don't even realize that we offend each other, that we bother each other. Now, as a good Christian, of course, we're supposed to have forgiveness ultimate and let all of these things go and say, I forgive you, my brother, my son, whatever it happens to be. And we don't carry any enmity against each other, which is good, and that's important, and we're supposed to. But now we come to the ultimate manifestation where we have to actually show that forgiveness openly to each other. And that's why it's important next week that we try and come to church, not just for the Divine Liturgy on Sunday, but also try and come in the evening for the Vesper service, where we have the service of mutual forgiveness, where we ask of each other forgiveness of our sins. And it's important because sometimes we don't interact with everybody in the parish, and people might say, oh, why should I go? I barely even talk to these people. I've got nothing against them. They've got nothing against me. And yet it's important because inadvertently we may have done something. Perfect opportunity for us to ask for forgiveness so that we can start the path of Great Lent, a clean heart, a clean conscience, and to be ready so that as we turn into Clean Monday, we're actually now going, not just getting ready to go anymore. So that brings to the end, as they say, the pre-season, and brings us into the season of Lent. And if we're ready, if we're prepared, then the spiritual profits that we will gain throughout Great Lent will be that much greater when we, God willing, when we meet Him on the glorious and bright day of the resurrection, and we hear those words of Christ is risen, nothing will be able to take them out of our hearts. And we will know that those words mean that much more to us because we have indeed forgiven everyone for everything. We have asked the same forgiveness from everyone of anything that we may have done against them. And those things are the most important to us because that's what makes us worthy. Those are the things, the five paths to repentance that gets us ready so that when the Lord calls us unto Himself, that we can be ready to meet Him and to greet Him.